Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Here we're going to talk about everything related to research, history research tips, and make your research journey easier and more fun. So today we're going to talk about a really cool new digital history tool, and it's great for creating digital timelines on your computer. So if you're a teacher or a student looking for ways to create really cool interactive timelines, keep watching for some tips on how to use this wonderful new digital tool. If you're new to my channel, here I talk about everything related to research topics, research practices, research methodology, specifically sometimes for history majors, but a lot of these tips can be used for different subjects, and specifically for teachers, if you're looking for great new research tips, lesson plan ideas, and resources. So if you enjoy this video and want to see more, please subscribe and click the bell to be notified when I post a new video every Sunday.
So the tool that I want to show you today is the thiseyes.org timeline digital history tool that is provided by the Shanti Interactive, which is a suite of tools made by the UVA's Sciences, Humanities, and Arts Network of Technological Initiatives. And here they have several digital tools that you can try out, but the one I wanted to showcase today is Visualize. Visualize works with HTML, and it also is interactive and integrates images, maps, charts, video, data, any other kinds of interactive features that you might want to add to a timeline. So if you click on the Visualize software from the main page for Shanti Interactive, you'll see the opening page appear here. And what you want to do after you start with the introduction is click on the Authoring Visualize Projects button over here on the right. And from here you have two options. You can either download the authoring guide on the top, or you can watch a video, a screencast that was put together that goes over all of the basics for how to create a project using this program. What it does is it uses a Google spreadsheet to record and save the inputted information that you want to include in your timeline and in your map. So it's really interesting, and it has a lot of options that you can use, but some of the things that you might find challenging, I'm going to point out to you to give you a few pointers when you're starting to use this program. So if you click on the authoring guide, it will open up for you as a Google Doc. And the table of contents on the left here is very useful to skip ahead to different sections depending on what you want to work on. It also gives you a good introduction of how to start and open a new project. So you do have to connect it to your Google Docs in order to have a new project, or in order to start a new project, but it does give you the details of how to do that and how to use a spreadsheet through Google Docs that records all the inputted information for you as you're using the program, so that you don't have to physically input it into the spreadsheet yourself. It has some really nice tools that automatically help you do that. So different kinds of information that you can include in your spreadsheet include events, overlays where you can place other photographs of maps or other images on top of different locations on the map. You could add stories to enhance your timeline and to give more background information about different events. You can also draw a path or a line between different points on the map in order to create a flow or to show a chronology or time frame that way. You can also create smaller stories or booklets that you can have multiple pages of that pop up in a window that works similar to a story, but it's for a specific event, and works when you click on it or create a macro element that calls up the booklet for you. You can also segment your timeline if you want to skip ahead or have certain elements a group together on the timeline, you can also do that as well with this program.
So I'm going to show you how to get started creating your own project using a Google Docs spreadsheet. You'll want to open up Google Sheets. And open up a new blank project here. And go to Untitled Spreadsheet up here at the top, and you can insert a title that you want it to be. We'll do practice for now. And then over here on the right, where there's the green share button where it says private to only me, you're going to click on that button and then go up to where it says get shareable link and click there. Now it will give you a link that you can then embed in the program that will let you create your own project. So click copy link, and that will copy to your clipboard for you. And then you're going to go back to the visualize program here, and you'll then scroll down to where the gear icon is on the bottom right here. And there is an input here for spreadsheets. So you can clear that out and paste the Google link or URL that you just copied from your Google Doc page. And then you go to options right here on the right of options. There's a number, and this is the number that will be assigned to your project. So when you see this number change, you'll know that it's a different project than the one you start with here. And to do that, you will click on the menu here and click Save As, and it will give you a warning here, a pop-up that says this will create a new project with a new project number. If you want to save into an existing project, pick the Save option instead. But because we want to create a new project, we're going to click Yes. And then you have to enter your information here to log in. So I'll do that quickly for you. And once you log in, it will give you a new number here to the right of options. So we now have number 2668. And click OK. And that clears off the project for you, so you can start a new project. So there are different ways you can edit the main menu here. You can see the title for your project here if you want to edit that. I can show you how to do that. So go to the gear again, and then where it says title, you can edit that to whatever you want it to be. And click OK. And you can see that it updates for you. In order to make sure that you save all of your changes, though, you do want to go back to options and click Save. Click Save so it saves again to your project, and click OK, and that way it will save to your Google Drive's spreadsheet. So that is the basics for how to create a new project using the Visualize program. I found it really helpful to watch the screencast that they made for it, but I also have referred to this Google Doc, the authoring guide, several times as well while going into different areas and trying out different features that they have. Those are the beginning steps of how to create and open your own project in VizEyes. So that is how to create a new project in the VizEyes.org program. And if you want to see more, such as how to create some new events and change the dates on your timeline and adjust it, then keep watching for more information and more instructions. Thanks for watching.